Nike makes Colin Kaepernick the face of its 30-year anniversary campaign. And immediately on social media, video of people burning their Nikes, the stock is down 3%. Was this a good move? No, this wasn't a good move. This was, in a word, genius! This is the gangster marketing move of 2018. Who is the most beloved athlete of the last 100 years? The individual that every brand in the world wishes they had their logo on? Muhammad Ali, a man who was stripped of his Olympic medals because he refused to sign up for the draft. We don't look favorably on people because of their beliefs. We look favorably on them because of their convictions, their willingness to sacrifice. And history is going to look back on Mr. Kaepernick very favorably. Where did I get these tasty snacks? Whoops. Yesterday, Nike. That's right. Just do it. This is the best marketing move we have seen in ages. It's bold. Michael Jordan summarized the viewpoint in the 90s. Republicans buy shoes too. It was smart for brands to stay out of politics. But unfortunately now, everything has been politicized by the White House. And the president has politicized all sports. The last bastion, the last oasis from all this bullshit has been politicized. So brands are forced to step into the fray. And Nike is on the right side of this. Nike would have loved to endorse Muhammad Ali. They couldn't. They endorsed the Muhammad Ali of our generation. And by the way, the math is on their side. Regardless of what you think of who's right or wrong on this issue, effectively, the organization has arbitraged or traded older conservatives from red states whose, by the way, disposable income is declining, and traded them in for younger, affluent urban consumers who tend to be more progressive. This was a good trade. Was this the right thing to do? We'll see. Was it the shareholder-driven thing to do? 100%. Nike just did it.